Have you ever been curious about how ski resorts always have the perfect amount of snow for skiing and snowboarding? Well, today we actually get to go behind the scenes of a real ski resort where they make snow to make sure that the conditions are perfect for your winter activities. Here in Ohio, snow isn't always the most reliable. Sometimes there's a ton of it, sometimes there's not very much. So they actually make their own snow to make sure that there's always enough. What's awesome about it? There's tons of math involved. So today we get to discover exactly how they use math for creating snow, what angles have to do with skis, and also how they use charts every single day.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too. It's all here for you.
Nate Wallison, and I'm the marketing manager here at Snow Trails. There's a lot of ways we use math here at Snow Trails, from our points of sale with cash being handed, credit card transactions, things like that. We do lots of inventory and quantities. With our snowmaking system, we use different calculations that help us to understand wet bulb and things that deal with temperature. And in marketing, we use click-through rates, different things that help us to understand the numbers and how are we doing? What does success look like? How do you figure out your reports and then make decisions for the future? We always want to make the best product out here. Our product is snow. When you take the right temperature and the right humidity, it comes together with a calculation called wet bulb temperature. And in order to have dry snow, to make sure it's not wet, I mean, everybody loves to make a snowman, which is wet snow. It packs together well. But out here, we want it to be powdery. We don't want it to be wet because if something gets cold, it freezes then, right, if it's wet. So we don't want ice. This is snow. We want to have a great product. So ultimately, being precise with snowmaking helps us to control the product, make sure that the snow is really good, and then it skis and snowboards much better.
All right, so exactly how do you make snow?
For making snow, we have a very complex process, but it breaks down into water and air and a little bit of pressure. So the whole process starts in our pump house. We have different pumps that are very powerful that push the water out to each snow gun, and we want that water to be really cold. So we actually added a cooling tower as well that can first cool the water down by 13 degrees before it goes out to the snow gun. The colder the water, the faster water can turn into a snowflake as it goes out of the snow gun. So it's a process that is really fun to watch. It's something that's really incredible. We're making snow out here. There's nothing fake about it. Basically, you take water and compressed air and push it out to each snow gun that has a large fan that blows the water out into the air, and then it falls, which is called cure time. And then we have snow. Our snow makers are out checking each snow gun throughout the process, but we love it. It's called a bounce check. So we'll have a snow maker out there with his jacket that's waterproof. And if the snow bounces off of his jacket, then that means that it's dry snow. If it sits and melts just right on his jacket, that means that the temperatures are either a little warm or maybe we are using too much moisture. So we'll back the gun off. We have different banks that can make it to where you're not putting as much moisture out into the air. With snowmaking, we have to estimate how much water is needed at certain temperatures, and then we reference charts. We use different resources like our online platform that helps us to see each number and help us to estimate how much water we can use at certain times to make the best quality snow. Yeah, in our rental center, we have equipment that's sized and set specific to you and your ability level. So you'll come in and our technician will take your height, weight, and ability and look at a chart and make sure that that binding for your boot is set properly to your weight and ability. Yeah, we have a ski shop here on site, which is really neat because it's a full service ski shop. And so downstairs we have different things that tune the equipment, skis or snowboards. And so specifically an edge sharpening machine that will angle your edge based on how much grip you need out on snow. That's something that you can do certain angles that makes it tuned different for each skier and snowboarder. And that's really cool because we have some angles that we're dealing with, and in order to have the right angle, a special machine is doing that for us and for each skier and snowboarder. Our tubing park has a conveyor carpet lift and a certain number of tubes that we allot per hour. So you take guests coming in each hour, and you make sure that we don't have too many guests on our conveyor carpet at one time, and even going down the lanes to make sure each is staged at the top and going down each lane of snow. So we take that and we figure out what is the proper amount of people to have per hour, and we set that as quantities and we put that on our reservation system. Yeah, our snow sports department has both ski and snowboard lessons taught at every ability level. We'll have first time lessons coming in, and we set those every half an hour to make sure that we're there and available for guests who need to learn how to ski or snowboard for the first time. And then we also have other levels available for private lessons and semi-private lessons. And so we'll set quantities available for making sure we have enough instructors based on how many people come in. And so we'll just align how many instructors do we need based on how many people are coming out for, say, a group lesson of 10, and that goes out for an hour and a half. You have to do some calculations to make sure that you have enough instructors. And then we're serving the guests as they need based on their lessons. Each of our lifts have a certain number of chairs, and we make sure that we space those out properly along the rope that we call, it's actually a wire rope. And so it's tensioning the system based on hydraulics. And so you can know how many people you can carry uphill, and you set these things with a system that's very sophisticated, but it's just a tensioning system to make sure that you don't have sag of the chairs and you're able to carry people up at a certain speed. And so there's a lot of different calculations that go on, but it's pretty neat and it's a fun ride and a great view.
Do you use measurement here?
So in our maintenance department, we have a lot of different ways to measure, take measurements to use in building something or fixing something. We have angles of different machines that you can get a different cut on a piece of wood, or all the way to our snow cats that have different measurements for hydraulic systems. A lot of different moving parts here, and so a lot of that means measuring properly, taking a calculation, and then fixing something back to its spec that would be the proper settings or the proper pressure in order to have everything operating as you'd expect it to out here and don't have any downtime.
How do you use charts here at Snow Trails?
We have charts in a lot of different departments, from our maintenance facility with different measurements for our machines, to our rental center with measurements for how we set these for each individual, even into our ski shop where we have service departments that make sure that binding releases are set properly for, again, height, weight, and ability. A lot of different charts that you can really look into further that help us. It's not always a calculation, it's just following the chart and using that. The other one is our wet bulb temperatures for snowmaking. That helps you to see what's the temperature and when we can make the best snow and use the most water to do that. Snow Trails, it's a lot of fun to get out in the winter and enjoy skiing and snowboarding, and we hope that you'll come and join us.
Did you like this video? Subscribe so you don't miss any more videos about real life math. Want to know more information about Snow Trails? Check out their website here.